Okay. We are officially recording offline as we're having some upload issues. But this is take number 4, and it will be uploaded to YouTube. Four times the charm. Hope everyone's having a great day. This is episode 7 of the Red Fast Review. Hope everyone's having a great week. And this episode is called We Talking About Playoffs. Have some NHL and NBA playoff talk to dive into a little bit. Which leads me into one thing I did want to say off the top before we kind of go around the table. Certainly had some significant updates in the game. And that being PGA Tour 2K21 this past week. And we have decent amounts of topics of discussion. And before we get too deep into it, want to just reiterate the point. The podcast intention is revolving around the golf community. A community that start and took off with the pandemic with TGC 2019. And grew substantially as the release of PGA Tour 2K21 released. And while many people may not necessarily have the same interest in the game as they once had, it's all about the relationships that were formed because of the game. I truly am so grateful that for all of these moments that we get to share each week and sharing these moments here with my co-hosts, Mr. Moose, Mr. Lobster, and Bear, who wasn't able to be with us tonight. But it does not have to be about the golf video game. It's about all the people we got to meet during this time. So, while we love golf in this game, we fully acknowledge that may not be the direction most of the community continues. And that's completely fine as their interests travel elsewhere. But, yeah, like I said, it's all about those relationships. I bring this up more of a statement to everyone that that we've personally met. I think I'm speaking on behalf of the rest of the panel and saying I don't want to lose those relationships. And regardless of, which way life takes us, I'll be interested to continue all of those and developing those further. And
I'll tell you where life's taken me on June 25th, Mario Golf.
There you go.
Rush, baby. Let's go.
Just a couple examples of that really just, made me feel great was just this afternoon I came home. Not a single person I knew was streaming PGA Tour when I logged on. So, and I follow a decent amount of people in this community, but not a single person. So for me to not see that in the directory, it was a little unfamiliar, but I did see Cartman Alf streaming and he was playing Apex Legends. So I'm like, you know what, let's go check it out. Cause I like Cartman and I've gotten to know him. Sure enough, he was playing with Hemo and I think perhaps Fig as well, but all golf relationships. And that's what it's about. So pleasantly surprised seeing that. I come home, Moose hasn't picked up Play the Golf video game in, I don't know, maybe 3 years now. And he's talking, chatting it up with Ginger Mane. So you know what? It's fun seeing those relationships build. So I did want to start off by saying that. And all that being said, I'm fired up for tonight. Let's have some quality time with some buddies and see what's going on. We'll break down some golf, some current event sports topics, and most importantly, what everyone's doing in the community. So with that being said, let's tick it on over to Mr. Robert J. Lobster over in the Bay Area. New fresh hat, potentially, matching the Rob Lobster colors.
In. Yes, indeed.
What is going on, Rob? How are you?
How are you, Kilbride? It's a pleasure to be flanked by my friends here. It's been a long week. Added some responsibility to the old employment at the brewery. Mm-hmm. Well, I am beat, but nothing gets me jazzed up than hanging out in a Discord, talking to my friends, and doing all this stuff.
Love to hear it. Love to hear it. And not working too hard, I hope.
Oh, no, I'm fucking exhausted.
It's exactly what we're doing.
I had a 15-hour day the other day. Knocked me on my ass, for sure.
15 hours, good Lord.
Yeah, if you're not from the Bay Area, rattling off the distance that I drove, going to 25, I had a 25 stop delivery run for kegs, full kegs and empty ones, but the full kegs.
You were delivering those.
Oh yeah, had to pick up some slack. I'm absolutely loving what I'm doing. Wouldn't change it Love every second of it.
Good.
But yes, as far as the hat goes, the Sacramento River Cats.
Ooh, not too far from me either.
No, the AAA affiliate of your first place San Francisco Giants.
Even more fitting. Okay, so there's more purpose to it than just you liking the hat.
Just a hat. More than just a hat a day in May.
Fair enough.
We actually give a fuck about this team.
our next host here, Mr. Mad Moose, over in my neck of the woods, New England. How's it going, Moosey?
Pretty good. Keeping in the AAA baseball talk, I just picked up a gig with the Red Sox AAA. Well, not with their affiliate, with their radio broadcast affiliate. So I'm doing promotions for them. So it's been nice to spend the last 5-6 days of my life pretty much at a ballpark, 5 or 6 hours. Would have been nice to be in the sun. Unfortunately, we're in the shade, so we can't really work on the tan. but seeing some great baseball, Kike Hernandez doing his rehab down here, hitting bombs, first grand slam in Worcester Red Sox history today. Rumor has it 457 feet.
So that team's been around for a while. This is their first Grand Slam ever.
Well, so the Pawtucket Red Sox have been around. This is the first in the Worcester Red Sox.
Oh,
just a relocation. No worries. Yeah.
How much time are you spending over there?
So we wanted to be at every game this opening week. So I did opening day, which was in and of itself 10 hours. And then each game after that, we stay until about the seventh inning. So like 5 hours. Because we get there a little early, so it's been about 30 hours at the park, but it's gorgeous.
And how many days?
Since Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, so 5-6 days.
Oh wow, that's a long day.
Good lord.
So yeah, would be nice taking some sun. It's not fully done yet because it started under COVID. So, but in left field, there's going to be a nice like grassy knoll area,
knoll
where they have like general
needs to come down to fucking christen this thing or what?
Oh my god.
Those will be some of general mission seating, which I'm very much looking forward to taking in as a spectator.
All right, well, with all that said, let's get into some talk, shall we? So we have an update yet again. Wrong screen. Here we go. This is the three person one.
So just to preface this real quick, mm-hmm. I haven't been at my computer, with the exception of like 2 hours last night, in about the last week. So I know nothing about anything that's happened in the TGC community or the PGA community for the last week. So this is all going to be new information to me as well.
Yeah, so let's get Moose's authentic reaction. I'm not going to say anything. There was an update. That's all I'll say.
I did hear about that, but that's
the live reaction as Pleated Pants is on the first hole of the Jack Wagon, and he gets into a familiar spot here.
Okay.
Well, we're going to figure this out. Because
all right. Little splash. 13 yards. He could probably chip this.
Easily. 60%. It was right downhill. I mean, it's impossible this wouldn't end up near the hole, or at least past it.
Oh, no. No.
That wasn't even fast.
No, the game. No. No.
There's a good 30-second pause there. From here. I'm not even exaggerating. So we'll go back to that shot again.
If you're trying to do a shot like that, you're gonna hit it thin.
Yeah. If anything, you're gonna skull it. Yeah, you're gonna skull it. It's gonna run off the other side. I'm very familiar with that in real life.
So shortly after, and this is the tweet. He goes to it.
Pushed out a small update that tunes the slow swings and makes minor adjustments to fall off distances when not swinging with good
minor tempo. That is more than a minor adjustment, so, let me tell you.
Yeah, that you know was him going to the tweet, and just for reference, basically what he goes on to talk about is, you know, obviously he's one of the pillars of the community, I think it's fair to say. You know, really had a growing audience, came up playing the golf game, truly like golf is his passion. He's a very low handicap, real life as well. But to see him that upset, like that initial reaction. You don't see that, and that speaks volumes as to what 2K did and how they implemented it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it's just a tweet. That's all we get.
Yeah. Just a tweet. I'm assuming there was no patch notes with this update either.
You thought there was going to be patch notes, did you?
Hilarious moose. We missed that sense of humor.
Yeah. Kinda gross.
So yeah, that's kind of the and I understand. And Pleaded later said he looks forward to the challenge of learning the new swing, but it's not necessarily the swing changing, because basically what they did, and to reiterate it, a very fast or even a red fast splash shot now is that as a result. I think, and this is just a hypothesis, but I think it's less penalizing if you do it in a bunker. However, I will play devil's advocate here as far as the reasoning behind the update and being quote unquote okay with the update. This is me here, you know, playing, and I'll go back to even Pleated shot. In real life, if you see this shot right here, mm-hmm. you're never doing a splash shot. And
no, if this is me IRL, I'm punting it or hitting a bump and run.
Exactly. You're chipping it. I know it's downhill, you want to check it up, but that is not a realistic golf shot in real life. And you know, yes, it's possible, mm-hmm. but there should be a high level of difficulty to it. But yeah. to change it and not really tell you is really the shocker. So this is me chipping.
If this works out,
that is a monster of a hill you got to get down.
Blue and he might get a woody.
But this is kind of the fun and I think creativity we can learn to do, as opposed to this is auto splash previously, knock it in close to the hole. Now it's, God forbid you miss a splash.
Come on. And now big turn back. Oh.
I don't make it, but
what a shot.
That I was obsessed with making that shot, that chip right there, and it like mm-hmm. was very rewarding. So that's me playing devil's advocate as far as the update.
Is that fast thing, does that only correspond to splash shots?
Yes. Correct. Okay. And what else they tweaked? Yes. So it's only splash that is penalized in that manner.
That kind of makes sense to me, because in TGC 19, the flop shot was my go-to when I'm close to the green.
Mm-hmm.
This year it's been the splash shot. Even I would rather hit splashes than flops. So I guess I can kind of see the reasoning behind that.
Yeah, and that's not the only update either. So there was additional updates that were made. So the red slow is now taken away. So that was kind of the overpowered thing for a while. And basically, you know, you could still hit a red slow and get distance, but now the red slow loses a decent amount, and the red fast is a little bit balanced. So I think they adjusted that pretty well. And also the pitch shot, a red fast pitch is not super, super penalizing anymore.
Oh, thank God.
So there's actually a bit of forgiveness there. So I think they were all decent updates, personally. It's just the lack of communication in how they do it. However, what I will say is, and this is kind of a discussion we were having a little bit before this update, if Joe Bumfuck in Montana logs on for the first time
great
in two
player.
Months.
CCA just
yeah. He's like, you know what? I'm gonna go have a nice casual round of golf. And he goes shoots that shot that Pleated just shot. What are the odds he turns off the game and never turns
it
on again?
I was gonna say he's not playing the game again.
We already have a smaller audience. So if I go browse PGA Tour right now, and this was even worse. This is a primetime Sunday night, but it is, you know, and that's because Killer Bees has 29 viewers, and I don't even know who this Boski is. But Pleated was at there was 100 people total in PGA when Pleated signed off the other night, and he switched directories to MLB because he's like, you know what? It doesn't even deserve it. But 167, that's pathetic. You know, there's a reason there's not a lot of people that are watching this game. However, I still love it. I love golf. So I look forward to seeing what happens in the future of golf. But
for every round I play, I will be in just chatting because I am not going to fucking promote this game ever again.
There you go.
Period. I'm not going to reward a company with an iota of advertising, of any promotion whatsoever.
Or
at the beginning of my stream title, it will say, do not buy this game. I haven't decided which is better.
Yeah. So
it's not like this is a small company either. This is 2K Sports. This is games, the company that produces NBA 2K, one of the better sports games on the market, at least more popular.
Popular and good are two different things.
Yeah. Sorry, more popular game. So they definitely, I feel like they aren't shoveling the funds and resources. They're kind of skimping out there when it comes to 2K, PGA 2K.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting to see what happens. Obviously, EA's, you know, signed a contract with, you know, they're going to be producing a golf game. 2K will likely create another one. So I anticipate just about everyone in this community is going to test out probably both of them, if not, you know, at least one of them, and, you know, gravitate towards one or the other. But that's kind of where we are with the update. But I think we've had enough said there, unless you guys have anything else to say. Let's move on. Let's have some more positive talk here. So, on a good note, we did have some gameplay this week. TGC Tours, Lord Byron Open at Tarakoi. We had a past champion win. Someone in the community who is a streamer. His name is Mr. Steaming Polak, Pat Hildebrandsky, aka Juanita. 8 in the world, shot 57, 58. 53, 61. How is that for scores? I think the last time I saw a 53 was my card last year coming into the clubhouse at my local Muni, you know, half in the bag, you know, just tallying up my total for the back nine. So he shot a 53 on 18 holes. That was quite the round, 18 under par. Let's take a look, quick peek at his scorecard here. He had 2 pars, 2 eagles, and 14 birdies. That'll work.
That's pretty decent.
Yeah, pretty good.
Any hole outs in those rounds?
We're dealing with some technical difficulties here, but let me see if I can bring them up one by one, shall we? Oh no. Let's see what happens here.
If we could make this, that'd be really nice.
Oh, nope.
Make this would be really nice. 1800.
Oh yeah. So this is the last shot.
Turn. Thank you.
He just had to ask it to turn. Is that what I've not been doing this whole time?
I'll take it.
What that's exact circles.
I was just gonna say, that's his famous famous saying. I'll take it. Turn. Can't complain.
Thank you. I'll take it. 18 under. Can't complain, right?
So annoying. You can hear it too. Not even like a slight grin on his face from being happy with that score. It's like, 18 under. I'll take it. Let's hope we can. We'll shoot for 20.
He
next
had
time.
Some absolute darts in this round. Let me see if I can go back. I had them loaded up, but due to the technical difficulties, I kind of lost a few of them. I think it was on 3 and 4. I don't know what he's doing for testing. Here's a nice one here. Into the wind. Constantly. His tempo this week was just out of this world.
Look at that approach. Left to right. Oh, what a bounce.
Just sticks it to a couple feet. I think he does the same thing on the... Yeah, look at this one. This was nice. Downhill into, you know, with tailwind too. Very difficult to stop in the right spot.
It is mouse and keyboard the way to go now? Is that like...
He's money on the tempo. I'm getting better, and there's still control of people. Like, Kolbster's very money on tempo. So is Sloaner. But if you can control tempo, like, look at that. Perfect distance. You know, he's kind of like Bryson in the fact, and the reason I say Bryson because it's the scientist that they always promote. Like, Bryson's doing all the math and calculations, right? So, like, he just knows everything. Like, the wind, this, bounce... Very firm's going to do this as opposed to, you know, firm might do that. And understanding every nook and cranny. So just fantastic golfing by Juanita this week. All right. Let's go on to the next. Oh, we do have
the touch.
Oh, this was. Oh, and by the way, this was round four. He knows he needs basically this chip in to win the tournament. He won by one stroke.
Mm-hmm.
It's automatic perfect every time.
Incredible stuff.
We'll take that.
We'll take that.
Just
fucking needed that bitch. Now we got three holes. Just don't go into the woods, dude.
Oh, man. Very comical. If you ever get to watch him, it's Steaming Polak on Twitch on the purple platform. So go check him out. He is climbing the ladder and perhaps...
Dude, he's a level eight. He's a eighth in the WGR. That has to go up.
Yeah, it's going to go up, and right now it's pretty much him and Sloaner that are 1-2. And this week, this, as we'll talk about later, this is not the only time he beat Sloaner this week. So we could have a changing of the guard down the stretch, but he's still only at 2 tournaments as opposed to Sloaner's win of like 12 of them or something like that. So
it'd be hard to dethrone.
Yeah, can't put the cart in front of the horse, but certainly a outstanding week. And right now, if you had my pick, he's probably the number 2 golfer in the world, right there with Sloaner. But I have to watch ads because I didn't have them teed up. But Sloaner,
Red Fast Review brought to you by Geico.
Yes.
15 minutes can save you 15% or more on car insurance. Use promo code RFR.
It also brings to the question, though, what have you done for me lately, right? So you could be, if someone said they want Polak, yeah, that too.
Oh, okay.
If they want, I would have no issue with that. Let's take a look at the man, the beast, the Mr. Automatic himself.
Hold up.
Love that.
Oh, my God. 2 bounce in the bottom of the cup.
No reaction.
When you do it so often, you feel
like I know. You know, there's a reason. There's a reason he's number 1 in the world. Finished 2nd this week in Platinum Tour. Very well done by Sloaner. I have one other clip. Oh yeah, we can kind of go down to that in a minute. Graham Singer, Dinger Singer, in 4th. Very nicely done there, climbing the ranks again. Love Scud, number 3 in the world, tied for 7th. Rossi, number 2 in the... Oh, I thought... I don't know who I thought 2 in the world was. Rossi with a 10th place finish. That's our Masters winner there. Sylvian Berger, 13th. Kara, that's who we have next. Kara, T17 in her best finish ever. A streamer, Kara Cakes. Taking a lesson out of Moose's book here with chipping.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Break. And...
Yes, nicely done. 2 eagles and 3 holes there. Not bad. But she wasn't done there. Almost the exact same shot.
Yeah.
But you gotta hit it perfect. And she does. Yes. 3 eagles and 4 holes. Not too shabby. Very well done, Kara. Congrats on the T17 finish. Okay, let's go. There's one more clip, and this is gonna set some people off that we're even showing it. This is for Rick Souza. From Beautiful Brazil. Serena.
Thank you.
Looks like Brazil.
He's a professional moose. Relax.
122 meters.
Man.
And. Yeah, just hammer that Y button. Thank you.
Oh my God.
Mark casual one on the card.
Why button?
And that's the public service announcement to that will be the last time we show a fully fast forwarded clip, even if it's an ace.
But the way this game's going, this should be the last fucking golf clip we ever.
Yeah, that's true too. Oh man! All right. Well, there's that. That was Platinum Tour in a nutshell this week. Let's move on to Elite Tour briefly. We had Mr. Jonathan Berg, 48 under, very nicely done. Moose's boy, all bag, no shaft is his name on PS4. Nicely done there. Congrats on the promo. What did I have? I had one clip here. This was from Mr. Supreme Binks.
Ooh, I don't think we've shown a Binks clip yet.
No.
All right, watch this chat. The wind's not that bad. I'm going to go.
This is on the 72nd hole. Where is he? Michael Binks. To get the T18 to earn a promo. If he's one shot further back, doesn't get a promo.
He's going to go hopefully into those red hills.
Speaking of the hammer the Y button.
Mm-hmm.
Using that little back ridge there, setting himself up for eagle, in which he would make. I probably don't need a fast forward because he doesn't even think twice. That is one good thing about Supreme Binks. And if you do have interest in watching this game, he plays at such a rapid Nova speed rate. It is kind of enjoyable to watch. I mean, as opposed to, you know, some of these streams, you're pulling your hair out because it's one shot every 20 minutes. So
yeah, and take like 10 practice swings.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nothing wrong with that, but I need a faster pace of play.
Mm-hmm. I'm sending you a link here, Kilbride.
Cool.
For a clip. Forgot to do it earlier. Speaking of Binks.
Okay.
Because when we're talking, if we have a spot where we're talking about the old alt shot all-star league.
We do. Let me find where I am. Here we go. And I will save that for later. Okay, perfect. And now let's go on to the next topic. Okay, yeah, so we'll just briefly touch base. David Engelbretson, Egg Golf Hazard, won on a nice little tie break here. They both had 62s final round, so it actually went back to third round tie break and winning and advancing to elite. So congrats on that. I think John Powell's going to move up either
that's
way.
That's 60, though.
Yeah.
That's, I mean, you look at that guy, Matt Jensen, who had a 58 round.
Mm. Yeah.
And he just has that Sunday meltdown, unfortunately.
Definitely had
Sunday,
the chance.
Sunday meltdown.
So as
he went full Sergio, as we say about him.
As we discussed, it's less and less golf centric here. So we're going to kind of breeze through. Don't have any other further clips on that. We do have some other stuff in the golf community that's probably more prevalent in most of our lives. For example, Alt Shot All-Stars. One of the best things I think we do in this, revolving around this game. Now, maybe some people's interest is fizzling out, but I truly enjoy getting together, meeting a new tandem, or even if you're familiar with the other tandem that you're playing against, just shooting the shit and having a good time. So,
hey, real quick, can you see who I'm supposed to play in week six? I haven't checked yet. I'm just kidding.
Why is this Zoom so difficult?
There it is.
Who did you guys have? Did you guys play Supreme Sauce? Ooh, so
yeah.
You did just send this.
We were down five holes after like six. Okay. Mm. And me and Toxic made a startling comeback.
Mm.
So we're both just off the tee here.
That's because you've never been to my channel, T-Sauce. Oh, my God. Oh.
Oh. All
right, count me in. I'll be in there. When do you stream? Lippity-doo-dah.
Lippity-doo-dah.
I'm not adjusting for that. Oh, okay, you did.
Thanks.
What a chip.
Nicely done.
The best chipper in the fucking game!
Was
oh man
was.
Yeah, formally playing in the game. Best best chipper on the just chatting net directory.
Yeah.
I am the best chipper south of the Oregon border, north of the Golden Gate Bridge. Period. And west of Sacramento.
So we have Fox and Blue still undefeated, as well as Narwhal and Bulldog, the Horn Dogs, tying them. So keep on the lookout for them. Putt Buddies and Ginger Hen leading the way, 4-1 apiece on the Splash Division. That's actually my opponent this week, the Putt Buddies. So maybe we'll have a little action and live stream there. Okay. Next on the docket is, I believe, Mr. Lextron. Because not only does he do the All Trot League, every once a month, he does a Bit Barrage, which, for those who are not familiar, is a bunch of the golf community members hop into Lex's stream, browse a bunch of different streams, find someone who's, you know, just casually playing, but they're affiliate, they're a streamer, and probably doesn't have much support, go surprise them and each toss in a buck. And just the amount of people and the interaction, this is one of them. This guy is just so confused. And like the confusing looks, that we've had better reaction. Yeah, look at him, big smile. He ends up getting so many emotes on the screen, he doesn't even know what to do because he has that, whatever it's called, Kappa Gen going.
Emote wall.
Dude, shout out to Mike, though. Always just, when that shit happens, is, like, the most generous guy.
Oh, yeah, drinking no things?
Yeah.
Literally That's breaking so funny. This guy's stream.
That's very obnoxious.
Awesome.
Yeah. And then the bits come in. So it's if you wanted to go say hello, toss this gentleman a follow. It is wildman_206. Big props to Lextron for hosting it once again, usually once a month. So if you want to follow him, Lextron on Twitch, and he will definitely be doing another one, I'm sure, probably another month or so. All right.
I got some bills piling up, so if Lex ever wants to, you know.
Yeah.
Just go make an alt account quick.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see where the wind blows us, because I don't even know what the next clip is.
I was waiting for somebody to make a blob lobster.
Oh, here we go. So we have the Night Wolf event. So we'll quickly touch base on this event. But before we do, I think we're owed a public statement from Mr. Rob Lobster in a report from the San Francisco Examiner. The one and only Geriatric was seen in parts of the Bay Area while scouting for the next Night Wolf event. Now, while no further stories developed from this sighting, I caught wind from TMZ, who obtained a picture of Mr. Geriatric meeting up with Lobster himself in what appears to be a conflict of interest in the Alt Shot League.
Oh, boy.
Now, warning. This post contains graphic images that may be disturbing to viewers and is rated TVMA. Viewer discretion is advised. Where is it? There he is. Mr. Geriatric and Rob Lobster hanging out.
I don't. It's not on the.
You don't even see it? God damn it.
Wait, what is
Hold
it?
On.
I'm so confused.
You can't see it.
Nope. You would have to share your screen for that.
I have to go to Discord. Stop streaming. Share screen. Screen 2. Go live. Perfect. There they are.
Who made that?
Who dad did?
Oh, that's fucking great.
That's awesome.
I think he was just
Sean Avenue teammate.
Yeah, exactly. So Connie and Sean might have something to say about this, but
this is that's hilarious.
When he said that to me, I just had to make up a story behind it.
That's great. I haven't been written like that in ages.
Yeah. All right.
That's great.
So we did have a Nightwolf event that was played, and circling back to what we were discussing at the top of the hour or top of the podcast, Nightwolf event was all about having a good time. And as you can see, these scores, no one's really doing that well, but they're having a good time. It's a couple people who don't normally play golf together. Hudad, Lextron, and Hudad's wife, Mrs. Hudad, N-Bonds 007. But Jerry had a nice little shot here, so let's show off Jerry.
Remember that tree.
Yeah, I know, jeez, right? He's using this funny little view, too.
Oh, this is the bear view.
Mm-hmm. Bear uses this?
Yeah, a lot of people like this camera.
Yeah, Bear switches up, I
think. As well.
Look at that, nice little 3-iron.
Come on, Jerry.
98% power.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Jerry.
Trickles a little bit past.
No, we'll take that.
Look at that fucking face.
This, the hat, too. The hat and the underbite get me.
Dude, he looks like a reject from the Finding Nemo movie.
Banging it home.
Nemo's grandpa.
Ready to fight back.
Yeah.
For the birdie too, that chip you saw in earlier for me that I was showing, that was also from the Nightwolf event. That was my final hole, so that was a fun time. Great as always. Thank you, Hudad, for hosting it. Fun time. So we'll see if there's gonna be another one down the road, but I think that we're taking at least a couple months off. It's gonna be a seasonal thing. All right, advancing further on, we had the Killer Bees Match Play Invitational Finals. And I had several clips from this, but it looks like this is the only one that carried over due to our technical difficulties. But Juanita was up.
We've talked about golf enough.
Yeah, 1-0. This was the final nail in the coffin here.
Nice. Oh, because they're on different platforms, huh?
Yeah.
I was hoping to analyze what he could do with that shot.
Zipping it back, dialing it in right next to the hole. Killer Bees, one of the best people in the community, very welcoming. Killer Bees 132, go check him out. The tournament has concluded. I wish I was able to gather a little bit more clips that we could show. But
did he shorten his name?
Killer Bees 132? No, it's always been that.
Oh, I thought it was like an underscore. Oh, that's on Twitter.
Maybe. Oh, okay, maybe. But huge props to Stephen Pollack winning a match play versus Sloaner. Not something many people can say they came up victorious 2-0. On top of. Yeah, 2-0.
2-0.
Yeah.
Swept.
2-0.
And he beat him out flat.
Yeah, and a couple times Sloaner was up, too, in this, too. So it was back and forth, and then Sloaner had some poor shots. It was a combination of Juanita going out and winning it and Sloaner, you know, being, a little bit behind where they normally are. Oh, do we have more here? What is this?
I was hoping to analyze what he could do with that shot.
This is the one I already had.
Yeah.
The souse. The sausage sauce.
Extra sauce. What's this? Oh boy, I'm a little scared when I don't know what it is.
Who is it? Goes,
hey, look. Okay. Same video. How many times can we look at it? Hence the technical difficulties. Oh, okay. So we're switching it up. We are switching it up. So as we mentioned, we are steering gears. We are not talking all golf.
It's a sexy dude right there.
Yes, it is. We're dedicating more time to other stuff that most of us are occupying our times with, including Mr. Rob Lobster's stream of over 200 packs. Wait, yeah, it might have been over really 300 by the time you were all done grabbing more packs. But
yeah, well,
how did that go, Rob? We'll watch this clip. This was the very first pack.
Yeah.
So that was
started
fun.
Real good. Ended a little flat. First pack of the day. Ooh.
Look at that face.
You can see my surprise.
Priceless.
Is it a double?
Look at the face again, Moose.
First pack of the day.
Like a kid on Christmas.
Way to start the day right
there.
Ladies
and gentlemen.
Yeah.
Bear calls it ballin' for
gold players. I did see something on Twitter. I don't know if this is it.
Ballin' pack.
Or sorry, not Twitter. TikTok maybe? I don't remember.
Diamond.
Ooh, yeah. Fresh to TikTok.
You might Robert have taken J. Lobster,
the
43rd.
Let's see. Yeah, just fast forward about 30 seconds.
All right, it's a Yelich.
It's a duplicate.
That's okay.
It's a duplicate. Yeah, no, it's great.
Either way, it was still fun. 230 packs later or whatever, you probably have.
Well, no, so hey, keep going. Keep play.
Lobster. Yeah, the very next pack.
Yeah, the next pack.
Oh, my goodness. Same
we go
spot?
We go back to back. It's a, yeah, Bond is a habit.
I've still never got a diamond from
you. Oh, actually, this is a great...
No, it's not dread, so it's not tattoos.
What happened? What is it?
It was a great clip. I'm just remembering now.
Oh. No, it's Rendon. It's literally, he's the least valuable diamond now. Less than 10,000. Yeah.
Yikes. I should probably buy him then.
Let's take a look at this.
Oh, no.
Rally cap? Okay.
Oh.
I was. Oh, it doesn't have the beginning of it. Somebody, a clip.
Oh, it's on my shoulder.
Somebody, oh, that's what it is. Ha ha ha. That's the
Los
one.
Los Angeles Dodgers. And, no. I meant.
Maybe. No, maybe. No, it's not that one. But it's, somebody goes, you forgot to pick the lobster. And it's on my shoulder. And I'm looking around my desk. And I'm like, where the fuck did I put the lobster? And it's literally on my shoulder. And I just felt like the biggest idiot. It's like when you're like, where is my phone? I can't find my phone.
You're on the phone. Hang on. I need to look at my phone.
Dude, yeah, I'm looking for my phone.
I picture of my new pop socket to somebody the other day. And I was like, oh, it's I can't. It's literally glued to my phone. Fuck. Unbelievable.
Oh, man. Moose.
Those are so
jerseys.
Sexy.
Hartford Whalers, you like them?
I love it.
It's a little too neon for me, personally.
I agree. A little bit bright on the green, but like the chest one's good.
The logo's beautiful.
I think the chest one's
clearly
really
downloaded,
nice.
But that's okay.
Yeah, love that.
No, it's perfect. It's if he can deepen the accents a little bit more, it'll be. Wow.
Yep.
So what else is going on in MLB? You guys been you just been grinding out. You have Trout now?
No, I mean I pulled Trout offline.
That's what I thought that clip was gonna be.
No. Very I pulled nice. It offline, and my wife goes from the other room, goes, "What's wrong?" I go, "Nothing. Everything's beautiful.
Everything's great.
Everything's perfect." He's not. But this is the thing. He's not even on my team. He's on my bench. He's a pinch hitter. But it saved me $400,000. So
who's your center fielder?
Mr. Byron Buxton.
Okay.
Very nice. So I haven't been playing too much of the show, so I still have to catch up a little bit. You guys are
I'm
ahead
right
of me
there
on
with
that.
You. No, I'm not very much ahead of you. I'm only on like
Moose has been living the show in Worcester.
You started on pinpoint pitching though, Moose, right?
I did.
You like that?
Look,
so did
me
I.
and Rob both. I'm about three games in, probably about, well, three games, not all nine inning games, probably like 15 innings in, and I'm getting the hang of it. It's getting a lot of fun. It's
there you go.
It adds a level of skill that I sometimes I was, and there's the clip of the Uber clip, if you have that for my channel, but like I feel like I just barely miss on the timing, and I just feel like I barely miss on the timing, and it turns into like the most atrocious pitch ever. But with pinpoint, if I just miss it a little bit, I can still get decent command. Mm-hmm. But yeah, this is what I was dealing with on my old command.
Just absolutely
right down the middle.
Yeah,
when he's trying to go high and inside.
Yeah. And it's just barely late.
And I'll tell you what, too, when you get, and since I can't hit perfects in any other game really right now, when you get that perfect pitch,
Uber,
it is so satisfying.
Oh, yeah.
Timing.
But yeah, always shout out to Uber for being just the most toxic
individual
I've ever seen.
Yeah. Uber's so, I forgot to mention, back to the Night Wolf. Uber goes into my stream Saturday morning. And he's like, Phil's winning this stupid thing again, as in Phil Hen. He's like, I got to go in there and change that. The son of a bitch goes in there and beats Phil.
Oh, my God.
He's first place, at least on PC, for Nightwolf. So that was too funny. I didn't even mention that. But, God, Uber. What a classy individual.
Yeah, someone said, not me.
I love Uber. Love you. All right. Moving on from MLB, I have from the Bespoke Madden playoffs, I advanced the second round. Take a look at this little move.
And this podcast isn't about tooting our own horns, but when we have excellent play, whoop! And when we have excellent plays like this, it's hard just to ignore. Yeah, love the USA hockey shirt, by the way.
Thank you, thank you.
Did you give him one of the whoops too?
Yeah, I have that. That man has a fan.
Can you replay this clip for me?
Yeah, watch me break this guy's ankles.
Whoop!
Guy just ran about 30 feet past me. That's probably one of the best Madden plays I've ever made. So I was very excited naturally at the moment. But you know,
stutter step.
Yeah, the old stutter step. Every once in a while, you press a correct button by accident.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me go back. Oop, wrong screen. All right, let's go next item on the agenda. Argue Hour, Disney Theme Parks Edition. How did that go, Rob? You had...
It went very well. We had James Just Plays. Yeah, twitch.tv/JamesJustPlays was our guest this week on episode 4 of the Argue Hour. We talked Disney Parks. We talked the best roller coasters, the best rides. We had we were opposite on almost every aspect of it. Mm. I, for one, love the smell of Disney water. He thinks it's rotten trash, which... I mean, he's clearly
interesting.
Wrong. But the big news coming from the Argue Hour front is that we are officially on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and this time next week we will be on Spotify.
Yep. So make sure you like, subscribe, and 5-star review, please.
Yep. The Argue Hour. You can head over to theArgueHour.com and RobLobsterGaming.com. And get all the information over there about the links and whatnot. Mm-hmm. We've spent a lot of time and effort putting that website together. So if people just, I mean, and I make no money off it. It's just for your guys.
I'll have it posted below in the comments
links
as well.
In the description.
Yep.
Awesome. Thanks so much.
In the description.
Well, yeah. You get the chance to rate that, review that, subscribe to it. It makes a huge difference with the algorithm. Us being Twitch streamers, we are at the mercy of the algorithm. And following the Argue Hour on Instagram and Twitter, and my new TikTok, TikTok.com/RobLobster43.
Imagine not
being get into that
TikTok nowadays. Couldn't be me. Yeah,
you're gonna be there, Moose. You're gonna be there.
We'll get you there.
You're just gonna break the ice.
Sometime within this next week, we'll get the TikTok up and going.
All right.
See if I got any new likes.
Next up, we have KH Lee won the Byron Nelson this past week in real life. So that was nice playing by him there. We have the real PGA Championship though at Kiawa Island Golf Resort.
One of my favorite courses in the world in South Carolina.
Mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that where it is?
Yep, right next to Charleston, I believe. Fantastic. Yep. Looking forward to that. Morikawa won the PGA Championship last year, so I personally, I've always been a Rory fan, so I'm looking forward to hopefully see Rory get another title. But I like to see dominance, so I'd like to see a close repeat champion too. So like if Morikawa,
you prefer
won,
somebody going out there and just dominating the course?
I want a close finish, but I want like repeat champions to like build. Like I would love to see Rory with 6 titles and Bryson with 5 and like Morikawa with 4, and they're all battling on Sunday. That's what I want to see, rather than some guy like KH Lee winning randomly. Like it doesn't get you as excited as much, I don't think, anyways. So hopefully it's a close, good Sunday of golf. Do you guys have any preference on rooting for anyone?
Lefty. Lefty forever and always.
Any amateur. Any amateur that has a piece of tape over his Nike logo on his hat.
Oh, my God.
That's my favorite.
He's not sponsored.
Exactly. And because he's not allowed to have any sort of insignias because it voids his scholarship with Stanford or whatever.
Yeah.
I just love that.
NCAA, gotta love it.
More stuff going on. So we are all big hockey fans, so we'll jump into that a brief bit. We have the NHL playoffs starting, hence the name of this podcast, Playoffs.
And the NBA playoffs.
And NBA playoffs as well. So Moose and I, both Bruins fans, Rob a Sharks fan, but we do watch a fair share of all the other games as well. all the first four or three or was it three or four, four games went into overtime, and you know, the our team, the Bruins, did lose. Yeah, did end up losing. Moose, what were your thoughts on the game?
So unfortunate injury to Vitek Vanacek there for the Capitals. I believe it was at the end of the first period, so about 40 minutes of play for their backup, Craig Anderson, who a couple years ago, you wouldn't mind having Craig Anderson in the net, right? Decent backup goalie. Decent, not great. 39 years old. I don't think he's played a full game this season, maybe in about the last two or three seasons. And you only put 20 shots on him and you score one goal. Marchand and Bergeron combined for one shot. I don't think the line had a goal. It just...
This is the most passionate I've ever seen Moose.
You need to do something else with that. I don't think the power play was great. Power play had one goal and it was kind of a fluky goal. Tuukka Rask should have had the first goal, but in my opinion, that's about it. He almost had the OT winner. Two crazy deflections for Washington to win that, but... let's hope they just come out and stay with the physicality for game two. And please do not hate on Tuukka Rask like much of the Bruins fan base. It drives me absolutely bonkers. He's one of the best goalies in Boston Bruins history, and I will die on that hill.
I couldn't agree more, Moose, with that.
Thank you.
I can't. I don't understand. Here is
look at this tip. It goes from 12 to 6.
Yeah.
I mean, and, he almost
it hit his paddle and just was unfortunate. It went five hole. Like, you're never going to think of that if you don't see it. So it, you know, he didn't really have a clear angle at it. I don't really blame him at all. He is, without question.
Did Tom Wilson get injured?
No, he actually scored the first goal, which was very unfortunate.
My pick to win.
Tom Wilson.
Yeah. My pick to win the Stanley Cup has already lost, gone down 1-0 in their series in overtime versus Narwhal and Bulldogs team, the Minnesota Wild, 1-0 overtime loss. So I picked the Vegas Golden Knights to win it. That's who I have money on, too. So hopefully they can bounce back strong. Rob,
42 shot shutout for Cam Talbot in the Wild.
Wow. Wow. Very, very impressive. Well, what were you going to say, Rob?
My pick to win is the one I'm going with my heart, and that is the Maple Leafs of Toronto. I want Joe Thornton to win a Stanley Cup before he retires, and if you've and my whole heart, it breaks my heart that San Jose couldn't deliver Joe Thornton and Patrick Marleau, for that matter, a Stanley Cup. But there is nobody who has played this game as hard as Joe Thornton and not won a cup. This is on level as Raymond Bourque to get Joe.
I couldn't agree more, and it seems like such destiny that it'll happen. Just the way that the Leafs are running this year, they look so good, but there are a lot of good teams
playoffs
left.
Are a different thing.
It'll be interesting for the Leafs when they have to play outside of that North division that they're used to.
The bubble.
And I'm wondering if their momentum and their dominance during the regular season is going to carry over, or if they're going to kind of hit a wall and not know what to do.
Sure, for sure. And that's very possible. So it's going to, and, you know, I think Matthews versus McDavid, too, would be nice just to see in that. And although I don't expect much out of Edmonton. One of the team is the Florida Panthers, giving Tampa a run for their money. Did end up coming up short 5-4 today.
That would have been the fifth straight overtime game.
Yeah.
And it was
nearly,
it was damn
two and a half minutes left. It was still tied. But
storyline of that game, Stamkos and Kucherov making their return.
Yes.
I think they,
You see the Florida fans throwing rats on the ice today?
Did not have a chance to see it. Yeah.
Oh, do you know the deal about that though?
No. Enlighten us.
Oh, okay. Oh man, I just got goosebumps. I'm so excited. This is one of my favorite traditions in hockey. So you know who Scott Mellenby is, right? In the, like, in 1996, there was, before their playoff game, there was a rat in the locker room, and he literally just took his slap shot, his hockey stick, and just slap shot it into the wall and killed it. Okay.
Oh, that's a normal move.
God, unbelievable. And so, like, literally, and so he, with the same stick, he scores two goals that night. And so they call it the rat trick. So now, oh, and that was in, and that was in the playoffs against, I don't know, somebody, I don't know. But like, so that was, yeah. So now show a video of a rat, like YouTube,
Florida
rat trick. Yeah, there you go. Watch that. Watch this.
Oh, right after a brief ad
for Joann Fabrics, use promo code RFR. So this is not, look at all the bags, and like this makes, you can fling a plastic rat better than you can frisbee a cap for a hat trick.
Oh yeah.
Oh, 100%. Those just fling it by the tail.
While we're, Google San Jose hat trick hat day. YouTube it, I mean.
Kind of off topic. Have you ever seen the AHL teddy bear tosses that
they
do?
Yeah, I love it.
Those are awesome.
Yeah. it is absolutely killing me. I have been spoiled as a Sharks fan. There it is. Yeah. It is absolutely, it's absolutely killed me to watch NHL playoffs and not have a dog in the fight. When the first Florida Panthers goal happened and they started throwing rats on the ice, it just made me miss the feeling of having a dog in the fight. So Mike Ricci gets the hat trick. Every 18,000 people got free hats that day. And so you know what's coming.
Oh my God.
18,000 hats are about to head on the free hat day. The first time anybody has ever scored a goal on free hat day. And my God, this is my favorite. Look, it's pure just nostalgia for me right now. But this is before
take back your hats.
This is before there was netting, so everybody can
everybody
can get their shit on the ice, you know? That's the best part. Look at this.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, I love hockey so much, dude. I love
it. The fans are just so passionate, so it's something else. It's something else.
And that's why it breaks my heart that my Sharks had such a terrible year, and now I get to root on Jumbo and the Leafs. Mm. Morbin Rain will be happy about that.
Yeah, there you go. At least, you can kind of say you have a dog in the fight. You'll be pushing for him.
Yeah, you get Jumbo.
Yeah.
Literally a dog, a singular player.
A singular dog. Any thoughts on the NBA playoffs? You guys have any preference? You must be a Golden State fan, right, Rob?
I am. I've been a Golden State fan my whole life. Dealt through the awful years in Oakland. Was there for the We Believe years. I am not a bandwagon fan. I've seen it all. My Warriors have a date with the Lakers in the playoff game, and I am one of those people who absolutely love the fact that they're doing a play-in for the playoffs like this, just like baseball does. Mm. And I think it's going to be really fun. Adds a lot of drama.
Yeah, I think you said it was the Lakers they're playing?
I'm almost positive.
The Warriors, Lakers, Spurs, Grizzlies,
yeah.
Hornets, Pacers.
So the Warriors and the Grizzlies played tonight, and the winner got to play the Lakers, which means they have two chances to win one game to get into the playoffs.
Jeez.
Yeah, that the Celtics have the Wizards. Another Boston, D.C.
In Washington, yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, should be interesting. For someone who, hand up, I haven't watched a single Celtics game more than maybe 5-10 minutes unless I was like at someone's house and was on all season. I'm not very into basketball as I used to be.
I'm right there with you.
And it sounds spoiled to say, but in all honesty, the main reason I'm just not into it, the professional sports as much anymore is because of how much success they have had in New England. So it just takes that like urge to get that first championship. Absolutely. You know, like I was a diehard Celtics fan prior to, and like being able to finally see them win, it was just, you know, it was night and day. So now it's just not that interesting. But that being said, I am probably going to consider watching maybe at least the fourth quarter of this. So the play-in game should draw you know, pink hat fan such as myself.
Drama.
Yeah.
Yep.
You guys been following actual MLB much?
You mean watching my first place San Francisco Giants storm Major League Baseball? Interdivisional action? Oh my goodness. We choked it over this weekend. We lost our bullpen, blew it twice against the Pirates, but still top of the heap there.
The Red Sox are in also first place. They have one more win than the Giants, but also one more loss. So technically, by percentage points, the Giants are best record in MLB. Very nicely done there.
The White Sox are also have 24 wins, I think.
Oh, 24 and 15. So yeah, White Sox are actually best.
Yeah, the White Sox have a 6-15 percentage.
But either way,
there, I get it on my phone.
Nicely done there. Should be interesting season. I didn't think the Red Sox would stand a chance. So.
Yeah, they're surprising a lot of people.
Yeah.
The Yankees kind of came back, didn't they?
A little bit.
O's dead last. No one's surprised about that.
Across the bay, Oakland making. Have you guys heard about the Oakland drama?
I was about to say, so they're gonna relocate.
They're threatening relocation.
I don't think they're gonna get that. I don't think they're gonna get that the park on the water like they want.
Nor should they. It's a terrible, terrible, terrible idea. But if I had my choice, and this is an unpopular choice, they move to Portland. Kilbride, go to PortlandDiamondProject.com.
I talked about this a little bit earlier on another podcast I'm part of. The teams I heard mentioned in the running for relocation: Vancouver, Vegas, Nashville, which would be really cool. And
so go to the ballpark at the top.
I don't
there.
Remember the last.
Portland. So this is a group that has been fighting. Look at that.
Oh, baby.
And so that is right there on the river in Portland. And go through that slideshow too. It's beautiful. They have, well, that's video. Just the,
oh, yeah.
Okay. No, they're just talking about the carousel. So that's a carousel that they had to move into storage, but they want to bring it back and put it back on the waterfront.
Right,
so you can see there, right on the water. This is one of the most well-designed, propositions to bring baseball to a new market. Portland only has the Trailblazers. Every time the Trailblazers are in the playoffs, they absolutely go crazy. They're the Timbers.
Structure over home plate is really eye-catching.
Yeah, it's beautiful. It blocks wind but allows natural light.
Yep.
I love the batter's eye back there with the pine trees. I am all in on bringing baseball to Portland, Oregon.
That would be sweet.
Look at that. That's the only downside, is that you can't hit home runs into the Witt River like you can in San Francisco Bay. But shout out to the Portland Diamond Project. Keep that fight and bring baseball. Bring more baseball. Imagine having a better rivalry between the Seattle Mariners and the Portland River Dogs. I don't know, it was just the first thing that popped in my head. I just think that'd be a really cool thing. They are doing great things in this Portland Diamond Project, and I as much as I love the A's and my friends who love the A's,
and the Coliseum, don't forget about the Coliseum.
I must say,
I am over billionaires getting tax dollars to buy stadiums. I'm over it. The Giants have a fully privately funded baseball stadium. The Warriors have a fully privately funded arena. These billionaires can afford to do it. Stop stealing tax dollars like the Marlins.
Amen. My only concern and flaw that I must point out, why do we have a horse carousel? Does anyone think that is a great idea?
No. So that's like a 300-year-old carousel.
Is
no longer historical in public access. Yeah. It's no longer in public access. So as a part of the Diamond Project, they want to bring it out of storage and bring it back to the public so it can be ridden again.
That's really, I love old.
Yeah.
I guess I spoke too soon.
Yeah. No. Hey. Can you believe that a guy from San Francisco has put this much research into
it's something important,
team that he will not root for?
Move away, please. I found somewhere.
But but on behalf of everybody in Portland, deserves a good baseball team to fight alongside the Rip City Trailblazers.
Very cool.
But that's just my thing.
Yeah.
But thank you for indulging me in that. I just think that's very cool. And if you like baseball, small market baseball is fun.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Love it.
Do you guys get out? Rob, you don't golf much in real life, do you? Occasionally?
I golfed a couple weeks ago. I just don't have the fucking time. And I'm also, yeah. What's the word? Awful at it.
Moose, did you get out this week?
Did I? I think I did Monday. Honestly, can't remember how that went. Yeah, geez. This week's been a blur. But so Dick's had to cut back on their hours next week. So I'm only working Tuesday and Friday. So should be able to get out tomorrow, hopefully Wednesday as well. And yeah, who knows?
Well, look at this fucking drive.
Oh, yeah.
This from here, from our correspondent that isn't here this evening. He was out enjoying himself on the golf course.
A little love for the lefties.
Just cranked.
Oof.
Like, sounded I expected good. The Happy Gilmore sound after that, dude.
Sounded great. Can't quite think of where the ball goes.
It looks
goes,
like a
but...
narrow fairway, too.
I know, right?
Yep.
Sandwiched by trees, flanked by trees.
What a hero wearing pants, too.
I mean, it could be chilly out there.
I'm personally, I'm more comfortable in pants on a golf course. I don't know what it is.
All right. Well,
unless it's like 85 and humid.
I'm a shorts guy. What can I say? Anyways, Bear, welcome back to the IRL golf stream. And congrats, by the way, on 11 years with the misses. Also tweeted out.
Yeah, congrats.
Yeah. Let's click those photos again. Oh, my God.
Mr. Pikachu himself.
Oh my God, I love it.
Too funny. He tortured her by taking her to a Browns game. God
yeah,
bless.
No kidding. Hey, that's the crazy thing. All of our wives are beautiful. Oh, sorry, Moose.
Yeah.
My bad.
Oh, wait, where did she go?
you need to update your credit card information.
What's under the blanket, Moose?
I thought I deflated it enough.
Oh man, I also did get out twice this weekend, shot a 97 and a 95, so not too shabby for myself. Both sub 100.
I almost got out with you today. That would have been fun.
I texted Moose last minute. I also texted Mac too. I was like, "Oh, that'd be fun," but he was away. But one of these days we'll meet in person and get a real golf.
Yeah, I'll be right there, guys.
Yeah, you're on your way. And I'll get my Mad Moose card. Authentic, signed to add to the collection.
Need to send those out, but I'm waiting for extra merch to send your way.
I still need to get a Sharpie or marker to do that.
Get what? Yeah. This is the ticket.
Mm-hmm. You got a link for those?
Deco color. You can get it from the Joanne's fucking link we just saw on YouTube.
No kidding.
It's the best. Here,
15% off.
I'll show you how good it looks. I'll sign one right now for you. And the color. It pops. It endures. I'm a professional at this.
Let's see what we got.
Look at how much that pops.
Mm-hmm.
Love that.
And as long as you give it a chance to dry, my three's a little wonky there. This would not be something I send to a customer, but it just pops. It has enough contrast, and it doesn't fade like a Sharpie will.
Mm.
That's the key.
Good to know for anyone that's out there thinking about they're going to have to sign autographs in the future. Make sure you think about that.
Yep. Anybody who wants an autograph card, just include that in the notes when you place your order at roblobster43.bigcartel.com.
There it is. Well, that's all I have for this evening. Anything else you guys have on your docket? Plans for the week? You guys streaming? Moose, you breaking out of retirement? You streaming?
Yeah, it's been a little bit crazy week. Hopefully have a stream tomorrow. I'll probably give golf a shot. Gonna be honest, not sure how long that will last. But we'll have a bit of MLB this upcoming week. I'm not quite sure of times yet, so stay tuned to my Twitter at MaddoxMoose, same as my Twitch for updates there.
And Rob, what's your schedule looking like?
We'll play some stuff. Monday, Tuesday. I do not have an argue hour schedule for this week, but there's a good thing. I have a couple in the can. But the best thing you can do is follow my TikTok, tiktok.com/RobLobster43, and help me out and follow the argue hour at the argue hour on Instagram and Twitter. And then rate, review, subscribe wherever you get your podcasts.
Very nice.
How about yourself, Kilbred?
I will be streaming golf. I am still, unlike probably you guys, and Bear's kind of fading out a little bit too. I'm still pretty committed to the golf game. I truly do enjoy it. So I will be streaming on Tuesday, TGC rounds 1 and 2, Elite Tour, feeling good about it. So we'll see if we can make a cut. We did not make the cut this past week. That being said, I am also in the Madden playoffs, as you saw me juke the absolute living daylights out of that linebacker. And we are playing second round to be determined, but that will be sometime this week. So that will be the divisional round. I just played in the wild card round. So we'll see if we can go back to the Super Bowl where we lost on the last play of the game last year. We have a little redemption out, but our opponent has been kicked out of the league, so he is no longer in the league. So that it'll make for an interesting finish. However,
I feel like I want to know.
Yeah, I've lost 4 times since this year, so it's not going to be a cakewalk by any means. We have some great competitors.
Cake pie is better than cake.
That's
a good one.
That's something I'd like to argue you about, but that is for a separate podcast.
Do you mind? I'll plug this next week's episode. This week we have our friend BipolarBear_7 arguing about stand-up comedy. So that's this week's episode.
Oh, on Uploaded.
That will, yeah, uh-huh.
Uploaded to the podcast network because it was already recorded. Right.
Right. Cool. Yeah.
Details, understood. Details. Yeah. Smash, smash. Well, to all those that have sticked around to the end, probably sure it's very few of you, but I truly appreciate it. Hopefully you guys found this entertaining and best of luck on your cuts this week if you are playing golf. If not, enjoy whatever it is.
And, I'm a bear. You deserve it.
Exactly. As I think is it George Strait who said it? I'm not here for a good time. I'm here for a good time, not for a long time. Right?
Ha! I like that.
Yeah. So big fan of that one. So enjoy yourself, whatever you're doing. Ciao.
Bye, everyone.